animals can survive the dry period. So there is this nice system where you have like geological formations like these caves, and again, there's a lot of them. This is actually one of the smaller ones that bats start living in because the rain made these caves, and then because of the bats, basically the rest of the island can exist. Mm. So that's also why on this island, in addition to corals, like bats are heavily protected, because people sort of realize that like if you lose your pollinators, it's all going to hell. Much like the whole story with bees, like if you lose your bees, that like all your food production will go to hell.
Great to have someone to work with full time on the island and see really, really great job. So I wanted to say that. Thank you.
But this is sort of how it began. And then after that, like in 69, they made it bigger. So that was. And then in 2011, we got a big chunk of money from the government here to upgrade.
Marvelous exhibit here of the work of
this
SECOR.
This goes all the way around. Billy, this goes all the way around.
On the this nitro pot?
Mm-hmm.
Those are actual settlers.
And this is from last month?
Yeah.
And do you know how many embryos you put in here?
We had a total of about 100,000 embryos. And we ended up with 600 tiles with settlers.
Wow.
And do you still attach these with epoxy, or how do you?
Usually not. We just wedge them. But these species grow really shallow. They grow in between like 0.5 and 5 meters, so there's lots of surge. So we're actually testing that right now. We did half with epoxy, half without epoxy, to see if they
see what happens. Yeah. Thank you. Dr. Kelly, could you explain to me what's in this tray?
These are swimming larvae from Montastra cavernosa. We got these last night. These are gonochoric species, so we got sperm and eggs and we fertilized them. We had had five parents spawning last night, so five colonies. We had 100% fertilization rate, so they're all here right now. And we're hoping to get way more tonight so we can put it in our in situ pools.
So for each species that we work with, we always set aside a little experiment in which we track like what they do in terms of survival rates, when they start swimming, how much they swim, when they swim towards the bottom to start looking for cues for settlement. And then eventually we're going to add them little like settlement cues, which would be crustose coralline algae. So there's some kind of algae that actually they really, really like a lot. So we're going to add those pieces of algae in there, and we're going to track how many larvae are settling and attaching to the bottom. And that always gives us an idea of what we should do with the main culture. So that's kind of like the thermometer, like we're measuring their happiness and what they like and what they're doing, so we can make decisions for the rest of the culture.
And this is?
That one is cavernosa. So I'm setting it up right now, and then we already have the fibulatas, the other species in there. So now I'm just like putting in each, we start with 40 larvae, and then we track them through time. Like normally we actually count them once or twice a day. And then we start figuring out like how many are settling and how fast.
And there's Valerie sucking up.
Those are larvae now, because they're actually
already
swimming. Yeah.
That's why they were swimming.
Montastria faviolata. I don't know what I could probably tell you what the full name is.
Okay, everyone
smile! Look sexy!